I'm off back to my cabin to cook up a traditional Swedish dish, the Wallenberger. It's named after one of Sweden's most well-known industrial families. Naturally, I'll be putting my own twist on this classic and taking some inspiration from fast food.
There's nothing worse than a dry, rubbery burger. That's definitely not the case with my Wallenberger burgers. I'm going to start off by making my burger patties. Now, the key to this burger patty is using really rich, indulgent ingredients. You need either some pork mince, or traditionally you would use veal mince, cream, 4 egg yolks. The egg yolks and cream are going to add that richness to the burger. The egg whites you can save to make a meringue. You can even freeze them in an airtight container. They'll keep for a couple months. Generous pinch of salt and lots of white pepper. And then you just want to blend everything together. I'm going to put the mixture in a bowl, and that's going to go into the fridge for about an hour. You want the mince to absorb the cream and the egg yolks. So my mixture's been sitting in the fridge. It's a bit easier to form now. I'm gonna roll it in some breadcrumbs. I'm gonna add a pinch of salt. Toss that through. And then form this into 4 patties. Dip it in the breadcrumbs. Then flip it over to get the other side. And then pop it on a clean plate. The last one. Right, you'll need a generous dollop of butter in a hot pan to fry your burgers. And when the butter's singing, you can add your patties. You want to fry the patties about 4 to 5 minutes on each side until they've got a golden crust. See here, it's got a lovely golden colour on them. Crispy too. I'm going to put them on a tray. They're rather thick patties, so they need to go in a preheated oven at 170 degrees for about 5 to 10 minutes just to cook it all the way through. While the burgers are finishing in the oven, I'm going to make my pea puree. I'm going to add some salt to the boiling water and another pinch, just for luck. Peas go in. I'm just using frozen peas. And this takes about 5 minutes to cook. I'm using iceberg lettuce, a bit retro, but it's crisp. You don't want fancy rocket. It doesn't work for this. Some lingonberry jam.
If you can't get hold of lingonberry jam, you can use cranberry or red currant jam.
It's definitely not going to be easy to eat. It's a big mouthful, but tasty. Look at that colour. And then pop that on top. My Wallenberger burger, a twist on the Swedish classic. Kladdkaka, Swedish chocolate mud cake, is super popular at dinner parties because it's easy to make. But what do you do when you have friends who have dietary restrictions? Well, you'll have to make my cake. It's just as tasty and easy to do. So I'm using some sticky sweet dates as my base. It's going to add the sweetness. Put that in the blender. Some espresso. Now, what the coffee does is bring out that chocolatey flavour. You want to blitz this until you have a smooth paste. All right. Now, this cake is super easy because it's just about adding all your ingredients into the blender. So I've got some non-tasting vegetable oil. You could use coconut butter. Goes in. Some ground flax seeds. That's going to bind everything together. Some black beans. Not what you expect to have in a chocolate cake, but it will give it that muddy texture. A little bit of the bean liquid. Some vanilla bean paste. Cocoa powder. Teaspoon of salt. And some baking powder. That's it, we've got our cake batter ready. I've got a baking tin already lined with some paper, and you just need to pour in your mix. If you wanted to, you could do individual ones, like in a muffin tin. They just take 10 minutes to bake. So this cake is vegan. There are no animal products in there. It's also nut-free, refined sugar-free. Basically, it's free from many things, but not free from flavor. Okay, to my icing, I'm gonna add a pinch of salt, cocoa powder, and then the sweetener is gonna be maple syrup. You can add as much or as little as you like. Adjust it to your liking. That's it. Make sure your cake has cooled down first. So you just want to smooth the icing on the top. Okay, I'm gonna add some berries for colour. It's quite nice to cut the strawberry in half. Some blueberries. And then I'm just gonna shave some chocolate on. My Swedish chocolate mud cake, one to please everyone.